Welcome back to Upfront. This year in Milwaukee, 16 babies have died in unsafe sleeping situations. The latest death of a 5-month-old boy happened just this past weekend. Authorities say many of the cases involve the baby sleeping with an adult, and sometimes that adult is under the influence of drugs or alcohol. A Republican state lawmaker wants to make intoxicated co-sleeping a crime. Representative Samantha Kerkman's bill would make it a felony to harm or kill an infant by co-sleeping while intoxicated. She also wants to require that new parents go home from the hospital with educational materials on safe sleeping. And she'd make high schools provide education about the dangers of intoxicated co-sleeping. And Representative Samantha Kerkman joins us now on Upfront. Thanks very much for being with us today. Let me ask you, first of all, about the notion of criminalizing intoxicated co-sleeping. Everyone agrees that it's a tragic situation. There's been a push throughout, particularly the city of Milwaukee, city leaders, health officials, to better educate people. But most stop short of the notion of criminalizing this. Why do you think that's necessary, and why do you think it'll have an impact?
Well, I want to give the district attorneys another tool in their toolbox. This idea came forward from a case that happened in Kenosha County about 3 years ago. A 5-month-old was killed, and I just want to give them the tool that they need to actually bring, you know, a case forward if the facts of the case see it. You know, again, there have to be many factors. You know, intoxication needs to be proven. You know, in a lot of cases, you know, during the interview process, that is found out, you know, that they were drinking earlier in the night. And again, I want parents to make better choices. It doesn't, you know, nobody's speaking up for the children right now. And so far this year, just in Milwaukee, 16 children have died.
The key, of course, is prevention, and a lot of law enforcement officials will say this is a very difficult thing to prove. Is it necessary? Doesn't it muddy the waters, clog up the legal system, perhaps, with investigations that may not result in any sort of conviction
In any of the cases of the deaths, investigations are happening, and I guess I just want, if the facts of the case warrant, you know, that are serious. I mean, in one of the cases several years ago, it was twice they had done it. And again, no charges were brought forward, and it happened a second time. I feel that if a district attorney feels that the facts of the case warrant, you know, to be brought forward through the legal process, that option be there. You know, in my county, they did bring forward the first time the trial ended in a mistrial because it's difficult to prove under the child neglect statutes right now as they're written. So that's why District Attorney Bob Zaft asked me to, you know, to investigate this, to look, you know, for options. And then I also did put the education component in there. I feel that if we reach out to our younger people in the high schools, you know, tell them about the risks associated with this, and then, you know, upon the time of delivery, again, giving moms and dads more information about the dangers. Again, even Children's Hospital recognizes that in about 20% of the cases, alcohol is probably a factor. Again, during the investigation process in Milwaukee County, there's no blood draw that's done. In Kenosha County, whenever a death of a child occurs, the protocol is at a death scene is to ask the caregiver to submit to a blood sample. And so I would like to see that as well in the future, but right now my bill just includes the two components.
You have legislatively addressed concerns over shaken baby syndrome in the past. Do you believe that this rises to that level in terms of
16 children so far this year have died through co-sleeping deaths. Some of them, I believe, are associated with intoxicated co-sleeping. And shaken baby, again, it was reaching out to our youth to tell them about the dangers when they're babysitters, you know. And then, you know, at the time of delivery, again, don't just walk away. If the baby is crying, put the baby in a safe environment, in a crib, in a pack and play. Walk away for 10 seconds. Count, walk back in when you have calmed down, because I know it is very challenging. I have two young children myself.
All right, before I let you go, I want to talk to you a little bit about another issue that you have been very much in the spotlight over the last several months, and that is the casino in Kenosha, the proposed Hard Rock Casino there. Where do we stand on that? The governor has decided to sort of put it on the back burner for a little while as he says he gets more information. Where are we?
Well, he has a year and a half to make his decision from August 22nd. So I'm comfortable giving, you know, that he stood back and looked at the proposals that came forward from both the Menominee and the Potawatomi, that there's more information that he really wants to analyze, and I want him to make the right decision for, you know, southeastern Wisconsin and
that's approval.
It's approval. It is approval.
You've been pushing him to approve it.
I feel much more confident from our last interview that hopefully the governor will get to that decision, and so I'm willing to wait a little bit of time and help him with any information he might need to make the right decision.
Representative Samantha Kerkman, thank you very much for taking a few minutes and being with us today. We really appreciate your time.
Thank you.
And next on Upfront, we're going to walk through some of the changes happening right now with Badger Care and find out what they mean for people. But first, here's the WISN Politics Week ahead.
The Assembly Select Committee on Common Core Standards will vote Thursday on its final committee report.